The SR-71 Blackbird was a stealth spy plane that could fly faster than a bullet, reaching speeds of up to 3 times the speed of sound. It had a unique design that resembled a combination of a spaceship and an airplane. Even today, 50 years after its first flight, it remains the fastest and highest flying aircraft ever built without rocket propulsion. It was a costly investment that pushed the boundaries of 1960s aviation technology. The design of the SR-71 Blackbird was incredibly forward-thinking, as it was developed without the aid of modern computers. Instead, teams of people used slide rules and calculators to calculate the complex engineering required. The SR-71 Blackbird was a miracle of engineering, and the pilots who flew it took great risks to push the limits of what was possible. The SR-71 Blackbird was not only a technological marvel, but it also played a critical role in maintaining peace during a time when the world was on the brink of nuclear war. In January 1966, two experienced test pilots prepared for a crucial experimental flight. The aircraft that Bill Weaver and Jim Zwayer are about to fly is a highly advanced, ultra-fast covert military jet that has recently been modified to improve performance. Bill Weaver, a highly experienced pilot with 4,000 flying hours, takes off at around 11 o'clock in the morning, and they begin their routine flight. However, while flying at a speed of Mach 3.2, Weaver's engine suddenly fails, causing a startling and unexpected event. The plane, now unbalanced and impossible to control, pitches into a steep and catastrophic climb. The pilots described such incidents as being in a train wreck, and one can never prepare for them. When the engine of the SR-71 Blackbird failed, the pilot had no control over the plane and knew they were just along for the ride. Within seconds, the plane began to disintegrate around them. The effort to build the world's fastest spy plane was on the brink of disaster. The story of the SR-71 Blackbird begins in 1957, during the Cold War, when the Soviet Union developed intercontinental ballistic missiles. The threat of a direct nuclear strike on U.S. cities made it a top priority to gather intelligence on the Soviet nuclear arsenal. In any conflict, knowledge is power, and it was vital to understand the capabilities of the Soviet military machine. Conventional aircrafts were not able to gather the necessary information, so America needed specialized spy planes to fly reconnaissance missions deep into Soviet territory. The goal was to create a spy plane that could fly undetected by radar and evade enemy jets. In late 1957, the CIA approached defense contractor Lockheed to develop a new undetectable aircraft for reconnaissance missions. The project, called Dark Angel, was led by aviation genius Kelly Johnson, who was known for his visionary approach to design and his understanding of the art of the possible. He had a strong relationship and trust with the team, and was considered a father figure to many. Johnson had been employed at Lockheed since 1933, and he formed a small innovative design team known as the Skunk Works based in Los Angeles. This team was responsible for designing several military aircrafts, including the renowned F-104 Starfighter supersonic jet fighter. By the late 1950s, the Skunk Works had established itself as a leader in the field. One of the things that sets the Skunk Works apart from other aircraft design organizations is its approach of assuming a project is possible, and then figuring out how to make it happen. In 1955, Kelly Johnson and the Skunk Works developed America's first aircraft specifically designed for espionage. This single-engine jet plane could fly at altitudes of 20,000 meters, which was beyond the reach of Soviet radar at the time. The goal behind the U-2's design was to fly so high that it would not be detected by advanced Russian radar systems. In 1956, the U-2 aircraft flew its first operational mission over Soviet territory and returned safely with valuable intelligence. However, the onboard device used to detect radar waves revealed that Soviet radar had tracked the plane's every move. Initially, it was believed that if the U-2 flew above a certain altitude, it would not be detected, but this assumption proved to be incorrect. The Soviet radar technology was more advanced than previously thought. The only consolation was that at that time, the Soviets did not possess the means to shoot down the U-2 at such altitude. The Skunk Works team understood that it was only a matter of time before Russian missile technology caught up, with potentially disastrous consequences. They knew they had to develop a new, undetectable spy plane quickly. 50 years after its creation, the SR-71 Blackbird still holds the record as the world's fastest manned aircraft powered by air-breathing engines. The Blackbird has an iconic design that evokes emotions in people, not just aviation enthusiasts. The Skunk Works team began work on Project Archangel, a top-secret CIA initiative to replace the vulnerable U-2 spy plane. In the spring of 1958, Kelly Johnson understood that the new design would have to fly higher and faster than its predecessor to evade the increasingly advanced Soviet radar systems. As the missile threat evolved, speed became an increasingly important factor in evading detection and interception. The CIA had a clear objective for the new super spy plane, which came from President Eisenhower himself. It had to be invisible to radar. At the time, achieving radar invisibility seemed impossible, as radio waves from radar transmitters would scatter in many directions when striking a circular fuselage, producing a distinct and easily detectable radar signature. To reduce the signature would require a radical rethinking of aviation design. However, in 1958, stealth technology was still in its infancy. The Skunk Works team faced a formidable challenge in developing a new spy plane that could fly at extremely high altitudes and speeds, while also having a reduced radar cross-section. Over the course of 11 months, the engineers drafted 10 designs, each designated with the letter I for Archangel. Some designs focused on reducing radar signatures, while others aimed for speed or altitude, but none achieved all three requirements. The leading design was the A-10, which could fly significantly higher and faster than the U-2, reaching speeds of over 3 times the speed of sound, Mach 3.2. However, the A-10's shape would make it highly visible to radar. In March 1959, during a meeting with the head of the CIA, Kelly Johnson argued that the A-10 was the best design despite its radar visibility, as it was designed to fly so high and fast that the Soviets would not have enough time to react even if it was detected. There was ongoing debate about the best way to defend high-altitude reconnaissance aircrafts, and the CIA knew that the president would not accept speed over stealth. It seemed that Project Archangel had reached a dead end. Faced with the possibility of losing the contract, the Skunk Works team redoubled their efforts to solve the radar visibility problem. They invested significant time and resources into developing stealth technology, trying to find a way to modify the plane's profile without sacrificing performance. 2 months later, an engineer made a breakthrough by incorporating elements from other Project Archangel designs into the existing design in order to reduce the radar signature. The new design had a flatter underbelly and sleeker lines, which would cause radio waves to harmlessly deflect along the flattened fuselage, resulting in a 90% reduction in the radar cross-section. The new spy plane was put to the ultimate test to see if it could convince the CIA. Kelly Johnson presented the new plane, which would fly 8 kilometers higher than the U-2 and 3 times the speed of sound, while presenting the radar profile of a large bird. On February 11, 1960, the CIA approved a $96 million contract for the Skunk Works to build a dozen of these spy planes, now called the A-12. However, just 3 months into the project, a disaster occurred. The shooting down of a U-2 spy plane by the Soviets in 1960, in which the pilot Francis Gary Powers survived and was put on trial in Moscow, showcased the rapid development of Soviet technology. The U-2 had been brought down by a state-of-the-art radar-guided surface-to-air missile, which highlighted the limitations of the U-2 and the need for a new spy plane that couldn't be shot down. The Skunk Works team felt the pressure to deliver on their promise to the CIA of a futuristic replacement. The new plane was supposed to cruise at a record-breaking Mach 3, but achieving the speed presented several challenges. One of the main problems was that a conventional aluminum airframe would be unable to withstand the friction generated by airflow at such high speeds, which would cause the airframe to reach temperatures of over 300 degrees Celsius. To overcome this, they had to look for materials that could survive such extreme temperatures, such as titanium. However, the main producer of titanium was the Soviet Union, adding an additional layer of complexity to the project. The challenge of acquiring the necessary volume of titanium without alerting the Soviets to the fact that the CIA was building something like the Blackbird was a major security concern. The titanium was purchased through dummy companies to avoid arousing suspicion. However, working with titanium was uncharted territory, and the Skunk Works team had to develop new manufacturing processes on the fly to overcome the difficulties posed by the metal's hardness, which damaged standard machining equipment. Additionally, the high temperatures of over 300 degrees Celsius caused the metal to expand, which posed a problem for ensuring a tight fit of the plane's panels while flying supersonically. This created another problem, as the fuel tanks were integral to the plane's skin and it was a leaky aircraft. with fuel often seen pooling on the ground underneath it. Traditional aviation fuel was highly volatile and prone to explode at the high temperatures generated during flight. To overcome this, the Skunk Works team asked Shell to develop a new fuel, an exotic mix of hydrocarbons and lubricants with exceptionally low volatility, which they named 7 Japanese yen. This fuel was so stable that cigarettes and matches could be thrown on it without it catching fire. This was just one of the many creative solutions that the Skunk Works team devised to overcome the various engineering challenges. Thank you for watching our video, and hit the bell icon to be notified of our newest content. Stay tuned.